Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Eternal Evolution on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Eternal Evolution and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Eternal Evolution. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, the first thing to do is to open our main internet browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the next URL that I have highlighted in green. Now, you are able to discover on the screen. You don't need to type it, simply because there's the link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We arrived here on our own website of Usitility, at which we have a meticulous information on the best way to download Eternal Evolution on PC. We browse down a tad and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on the link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to enjoy the game Eternal Evolution on PC. As you can see from here, we access a great deal of pros of using the emulator. Then, we will proceed to download the Eternal Evolution by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. Next step is clicking on this button. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do is to launch the executable file, so we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I reduce the browser to view the installation software much better. The installation software is very simple. It includes a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path truly does. We simply just click on it. And now we see that we display here the path in which the emulator can be placed. If we wish to change for better this folder, we need to click on the browse button. Therefore we opt for another folder and set up the emulator wherever we want. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. I click on back. And therefore I click on install. Great. The installation commences and it is going to go forward together with the download of all these MB that are shown on our screen. When you save it on your hard drive, it might possibly be more or less MB. The download rate may go faster or slower, subject to your web access and depending on the speed capacity of the emulator servers. Right now they're progressing very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar that will fill up and when it gets into the finish, the emulator is launched for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator has already been launched, there for the first time. Before we continue on, as you can discover, it made a couple of software icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the one we are concerned about. Each time we would like to launch Eternal Evolution on the PC, we double-click on this specific icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should do the next phase, that is a must-have, and this is to access the Google Play Store. And we are going to click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is launched. In this case we need to log on. Right now when we are on this page, we must conduct this following step which is mandatory. So we just click on Sign In. At this point it says, Checking Info. It may once in a while get blocked in Checking Info, and it fails to advance. In that case, you can try to connect to your account after a few hours and it will surely most probably be solved. At this point, we are going to type our email and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address as well as its related password. For example, you can use the very same email you use at the moment in your YouTube account. So I am going to provide my information and I will go back as soon as I have done it. That's all, data inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and presenting us the twos. We should agree to them by pressing, I agree. After that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it selected and this will produce a backup of the data files on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can make use of this feature if you wish. We mouse click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To install the application, we have got to go to the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking that icon marked in green. Today that we are on the desktop of that emulator for Android, we observe that we find right here the install game option. We simply click on the button. Right here we have the video game. Let's simply click here on the install choice that I'm just displaying now in green. Therefore, it will start the setup. Straight away it will download and install the Android game. It usually takes a while or it may just be very quick. That all depends on our internet connection. It's actually finished setting up. back to the emulator desktop by clicking on the following button I'm emphasizing in green, in order to use Eternal Evolution for the first time. I am already on the emulator desktop, and then we are on the way to click on the brand new Eternal Evolution app icon that's been created. That game is launched for the first time. So there we have it, I am able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the sound level of that emulator. It is right here. We have the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we won't depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of your emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the max, we will turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is the very first one, we just click on that software icon that I am showing in green color. Then the screen is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. In the case that we desire to play the video game using all the screen, we hit that application icon. So we would without a doubt be enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen mode. To escape the 100% screen setting, push the F11 key. And we just play in normal display screen mode. At this moment I am going to explain you the computer keyboard mapping and that is definitely very helpful. That step we will certainly be able to use the game app a lot more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this app icon. It's now time to complete the required setups. I'll go ahead and leave the normal settings, however if you like to change it, you may very well do this without having problem. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our language. Once in a while it occurs that the emulator is presented in the erroneous language, such as, in Chinese language. So to set it in the correct language we go there to the cogwheel. So here throughout additional configuration settings, we mouse click on the language drop down. We could determine the language we wish, Spanish, Chinese, etc. After the language is decided, we could save, the emulator would restart, and the game app, the next time we run it, will also be in the selected language. Right now, there is another point that we will need to take into consideration, and it is that we will get a message from Google Mail indicating that a new device has been associated with this Google account. It will likely question us if we're the ones who have connected that device. Of course, we shouldn't worry, considering that the emulator is emulating an Android smartphone or tablet. And then to see which electronic device is currently being emulated, we come right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. And so we go here to the model selection. And right here we learn that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for my training. I hope that you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was helpful. If so, give it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and if you have feedback, issues or suggestions, leave them in the comment box down below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams from time to time, you have it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click on any of these training videos that happens to be showing up on the screen and let's have fun again in the next video tutorials. Bye.